lot of people are saying you're next in line to take over for Floyd Mayweather in that welterweight division. How do you think you compare to him now as a fighter?
I think I compared to him a lot. I mean, Floyd was an amazing fighter, especially starting out in his career. And, you know, I've been doing the same thing. You know, I'm about getting belts. I want to be undisputed welterweight champion of the world. And it starts this Saturday versus Lamont Peterson.
Why this guy? Why Peterson?
He was the only guy available. You know, I just didn't want to fight just anybody. I didn't want to showcase fight. I wanted to fight, you know, a top contender, you know, a top guy. And Lamont Peterson, he's tough. You know, some people say he beat Danny Garcia. So I wanted to fight a guy that I can show my skills against.
Keith Thurman wasn't available? I mean, he's got two of the belts. You got the third. He wasn't available?
Nah, Keith Thurman wasn't available. He didn't answer the call.
He didn't answer the call? You heard that, Max? He
said, well, that's a fight that's going to marinate before they make it into a big fight. And let me ask you this, Errol, because I ask guys like you, and by guys like you, I mean special talents, this question whenever I have fighter meetings with them, Terrence Crawford, Vasily Lomachenko. When you survey the landscape, and I'm not just talking about other good fighters, because real super fights can't be promoted into existence. Dust settles, two dudes are left standing. Mayweather, Pacquiao, Ali, Frazier, right?
You know
Leonard
your boxing.
Hagler. The point is, I'm talking to Errol Spence.
Ask the question. We
don't
know
worry
you
about
know
what
boxing.
I do.
Ask
you do what you do. You
Hurry
do
up.
What you do. Point is, when you survey the landscape, who do you see that's another special talent? So when the dust settles, you think that's going to be my super fight.
I think the super fight right now is me and Keith Thurman. I mean, I have a belt. He has two of the belts. So why not unify? I feel like, you know, that's the best fight right now. That's the easiest fight to be made. We both had the same managers fight on the same network. So why not do it?
You sound to me like you saying that Keith Thurman is avoiding you. Is that what you're saying on national television?
Well, I'm saying I've been calling out Keith Thurman since I was 15-0.
Oh.
You know, it's time to fight. At first, he said he was going to bust my hot air balloon. And everybody was gassing me up. And he had nothing to prove by fighting me. I have a belt. He said he wanted to be undisputed and captured all the belts. So why not start and try to get my belt?
Errol, I'm not talking about, like, Keith Thurman's a good fighter. He's a very good fighter. He's talented. He's accomplished. And he's won some tough fights. But when I say super fight, I'm talking about that dude. That's going to be my legacy fight. Because he's like me. I'm a special talent. And he's just a little different than everybody else. Who is that guy in or around your weight class? Because I have an answer for that question. I think Stephen A. has the same answer. What's your answer to that question?
I mean, I really just don't know right now. Right now, it looks like Keith Thurman. I really don't know right now.
You don't
Maybe,
see
I know
Terrence
what you're trying
Crawford.
To get to. You're probably trying to say Terrence Crawford.
Yes.
You know, that fight's going to happen. Hopefully, he beats Jeff Horn and gets that belt. And like I said, I want to be undisputed welterweight champion of the world. So when he does get that belt, we can make it happen in the future.
Terrence Crawford, I spoke to him on a couple of occasions over the last few months. He expects to handle his business against Mr. Joe Horn. He wants Keith Thurman himself. But he also wants you. How do you feel about the fact that he wants you?
I mean, that's what he's supposed to want. I mean, he's a fighter. I'm a fighter, too. That's what fighters supposed to do. You're supposed to want the top guys. You're supposed to want the guys with the belt. You know, I expect nothing less from Terrence Crawford but to want me.
But
like
Keith,
I said,
do you see... Sorry, Keith. Errol, do you see Terrence as different from the other guys? When Stephen A., when a lot of boxing people, fans, media experts, even other fighters, look at guys that go, Errol Spence, different. Different. He punches, like the way he punches, the hand speed, the athletic ability, the heart, etc. But Terrence Crawford, also a different kind of cat. Do you see Terrence as qualitatively different from other fighters in and around your weight class?
I see Terrence Crawford different at 140. I don't know how he's going to do at 147. 147 is different. It's a different type of animal. We're bigger, we're stronger, we're faster than a lot of guys at 140. I don't know how he'll do at 140.
Hold it.
I mean, he hasn't proven himself at 140.
Hold it. Are you trying to say that Terrence Crawford, listen, forget about fighting me. You need to show that you can handle the other cats at 147 before you even think about me. I don't want to put words in your mouth. Is that what you're saying, Errol Spence Jr.?
I mean, I think so. I mean, it starts out with Jeff Horn. I mean, he needs to worry about beating Jeff Horn and getting that belt first before he talk about lining it up with me and Keith Thurman.
What's your suspicion about that fight, though, Errol? You know, like, what do you think is going to happen in a Terrence Crawford-Jeff Horn fight?
I see Terrence Crawford. Terrence Crawford should outbox him. I mean, Terrence Crawford should outbox him and beat him. But Jeff Horn, you know, he's a rough, rugged fighter. I mean, Jeff Horn always comes to fight, but I think Terrence Crawford should win that fight.